adolescence, I came from Kosovo. In this presentation, we look for self-reports of depressive syndromes, symptoms, crying, loneliness, hopelessness, and suicidal ideation in clinical sample of young adolescents. The point prevalence of depressive disorder is 1 to 2% in pre-pubertal children and 3 to 8% in adolescents, with a lifetime prevalence by the end of adolescence of around 20%. In community samples, epidemiologic surveys reveal lifetime depressive disorders prevalence rates of less than 3% in pre-adolescents and 15 to 20% in adolescents. The diagnostic criteria for depression in children and adolescents and for adults are basically the same, but the expression of symptoms varies with each developmental stage. Especially youth might be reluctant to disclose depressive symptoms, or alternatively, depressed youth might overestimate their difficulties. In some cases, children and adolescents have difficulties in identifying and describing their internal mood states. Suicidal ideation is one of the diagnostic criteria for depressive disorders, but not crying and loneliness. Crying is most frequent symptom at school age. Loneliness is a subjective experience and is a common part of childhood and adolescence. 20 to 50% experience some degree of loneliness. Loneliness may occur as part of a depressive syndrome and is often seen as a symptom of depression in most measures of depression, but otherwise is not regarded as clinically important and of uncertain significance as depressive symptoms. The our aim was to estimate presence of depressive symptoms in adolescents and examine their relationship between, in light of existing controversy in empirical literature, to estimate correlations between crying, loneliness, hopelessness, and suicidal ideation with depression. This study is of correlational design. The measure includes the depression self-rating scale for children of Wilson and the hopelessness scale for children. The purposeful sample was 104 adolescents, referred to the mental health unit for children and adolescents. Patients ranged in age from 8 years to 18 years. Mean of age was 15.5. We found that 30.8% of patients result with depression based on a clinical cutoff of the scale. In the graphical display, we see that crying at loneliness answers of the adolescents, and also the present level of hopelessness and suicidal ideation. We look for correlations, and we found that the level of depression is significantly positively correlated with age. Oldest have higher level of depression, with crying, loneliness, and suicidality and the hopelessness. Effect size is medium for age and hopelessness. This is a large for crying, suicidality, and loneliness. Mann-Whitney U-test analysis of sample revealed significant difference in the suicidality levels of males and females, where the females have higher median, but not for depression, hopelessness, loneliness, and crying. We look also for difference in depression levels, for crying, loneliness, suicidality, and hopelessness. And we revealed a statistical significant difference in depression levels across three different levels of crying, loneliness, suicidality, and hopelessness. The higher level recorded higher median scores of depression. The multiple standard regression analysis was used to see the possibility of predicting the level of depression from model of variables, gender, age, residency, crime, loneliness, suicidality, and hopelessness. Model reached statistical significance predicting the level of depression, where significant unique contribution given only by crying, loneliness, and hopelessness. In this graphical display is you may see the mean of crying, loneliness, hopelessness, and suicidality based on presence of depression. And as you see, the group with depression have higher mean. Conclusion: crying, loneliness, suicidal ideation, and hopelessness are among frequent depressive symptoms. Crying, loneliness, and hopelessness emerged as predictors for the presence of depression in a clinical sample. Future research should especially focus on the role of crying behavior, the strongest predictor in the specific cultural context. The findings might have important practical implications, especially in the context of designing parental and school education programs, which focus on monitoring depressive symptoms. This is one view of my country. Thank you for your attention. I see you.